English as a second language. In this topic, I would like to discuss about English as a second language or ESL and its difference between the traditional language teaching that we do in the classrooms and EFL or the foreign language learning. First, let us define what is ESL. English as a second language is an approach or a viewpoint. It is not a specific method. It is an approach of teaching. It is the awareness on the part of the teacher that when the students learn another language, they have already developed a set of habits in their native language. And these habits may interfere with learning a second language, or what we call L2. L1 intervenes with L2. L1, or what we call the native language, or the origin, or what is the student's vernacular language. ESL is an English language study program for non-native speakers. In an ESL classroom, the teacher teaches the language in context. He or she drills their students in the use of the structure, continuing practice until the patterns have been learned so well that they can be used with unconscious mastery, and by using strict controls and putting words and patterns into the student's mouth, she sees to it that they have spent their time learning to use correct form with as few errors as possible. Then she releases the controls and allows her students more freedom until they learn the language for the purpose for which it is intended, communication. In ESL, the teacher releases the systematic nature of language. She thinks of language as pattern, not as words. What is the difference between the traditional language teaching and the second language teaching or ESL? In the traditional language teaching that we do not set clear distinction between the speech and writing. So speech and writing are dichotomous too. We normally explain pronunciation, grammar, etc. in terms of logic or reasoning. We speak about the language. We teach the what and not the how. We also emphasize rules and standards of corrections. We do not recognize the difference between the first and the second language. And as we know, traditional language teaching is based on the philosophical understanding of the language. While second language learning, or ESL, we do not distinguish sharply between speech and writing. The two are separate, though related systems with emphasis on the primacy of speech. Oral work precedes written work. We emphasize the use of the language, explaining the whys about the language. We do not emphasize rules. The only basis for correction is standard usage. We recognize the difference between the first and the second language. And it is based on the scientific understanding of the language. We also approximate the process by which a person learned his first language. The general principles of second language teaching are the following. Number one, oral language is the basis of communication. Number two, language learning is not concerned with problem solving, but with the formation and performance of habits. Number three, language in actual usage is characterized by the speed, fluency, and appropriateness of utterances in response to stimulus received. Number four, the material is the course. I mean, the material of the course should be the language itself. Fluency and appropriateness or acceptable language use is the goal of the instruction. The ultimate goal of ESL is to improve the student's level of English. ESL classes teach different language skills depending on students' English abilities, interests, and needs. All programs teach the following: conversational English, grammar, reading, listening, comprehension, writing, and vocabulary. ESL can teach students to read, write, understand, and speak English more fluently by enhancing the grammar, vocabulary, and communication. Many reasons why students study English, for example, for academic reasons or for English testings like TOEFL, TOEIC, IELTS, BS, OPIC, CSAT, GED, and so many others, even for business and for travel. But what is the difference between ESL and EFL? We will know if we will define EFL since we defined ESL previously. EFL, or the English as a Foreign Language, is a type of English instruction that proves more challenging for both the students and the teacher. The country in which the students live doesn't use English, so the classroom may be the only place to acquire and use the language. The focus of the lesson needs to be narrower than in an ESL setting because a lot of times more must be spent presenting and practicing the language. Final activities should allow the students to use the target language and/or topic naturally, free of mistakes, and with free rein to incorporate material from past lessons. Thank you very much. I hope now that the difference between traditional teaching, EFL teaching, and ESL teaching are very much familiar with you.